Green screen effects have become very popular, and indeed they are a useful tool to be integrated into your animation workflow. How is it done in OpenToonz? If you know how OpenToonz structure has been defined by its programmers, green screening is a quite intuitive process, being controlled in the effects schematics. However, it's not so easy to handle at the first time, and it needs some practice to use it effectively. But good news is, it works. Starting from a green screen video I've made, we are good to go. In fact, it works with every color, but as in every software, make sure that this color is not part of the image you're using. It helps to know the RGB code of that color. You'll find out later why. RGB stands for red, green, blue. By digitally mixing these three colors, you can define every color generated on the screen. This green screen has the code 91-224-69. Alright, start an empty canvas in OpenToonz and insert an MP4 movie file into OpenToonz. If you don't know how to do this, watch my tutorial on how to import an MP4 file. The easiest way for Windows users is by drag and drop from the Windows Explorer. It takes a while for OpenToonz to identify the single images in the file and to transfer it to the X-Sheet. Go to the Effects Schematic window. Make sure you're in the right table, as the window shares the stage schematics and the effects schematics in the same window. If you do not see it, you can open it from the menu. Click on Windows and select Schematic. To apply the effect to the X-Sheet column, select the icon that represents the column and choose Insert Effect, Matte, RGB Key. The workflow is visualized. It's judged from the column input, go through RGB effect, goes back to the X-Sheet and to the monitor. Click on the effect icon. Now you see why it's helpful to know the RGB key. It's very important to have a clear color background. It's probably better to invest some time correcting it outside OpenToonz for better results. Type in the color code into the first row. There may be ways in OpenToonz to identify the code with a color picking tool, but I haven't looked out for it. If you know it, you can maybe help out others by writing it in the comments. Don't forget to turn on the preview mode, because you won't see any effect visualized when it's turned off. Now you need to experiment a little with the ranges. At first, set all to 100. You can already see the effect. Now go down in little steps for the color you want to fade out with better results. In this example, it's green. With 60, the image is represented clearer, or even 55. As you see a white background, you may not believe that the image has been separated. So let's draw a little in column 2. The image has been covered by the black color, and remains invisible even when I change it to a lighter color. But that's only because column 2 is on a higher hierarchy than 1. So let's fix it by cutting column 2 and pasting it on column 1, which shifts column 1 to the right, switching positions. This is how it looks after rendering. Thank you for watching this video, and keep going.